Uncle Gutenberg was a bookworm, and he lived on Charing Cross. The memory of his volumes brings a smile. He would read me lots of stories when he wasn't on the sauce. Now I like to share the wisdom of my favorite bibliophile. He said, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. 'Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook. Chapter titles are like signs, and if you read between the lines, you'll find your first impression was mistook. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book. Mary Poppins, can you give us an example? Certainly. Nellie Rubina was made of wood, but wood could not be seen. Was though her trunk of top was barren, while her roots were lush and green. So in spring, when Mr. Hickory saw her blossoms blooming there, he took root despite her bark, and now there's seedlings everywhere. Which proves a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. 'Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook. Chapter titles are like signs, and if you read between the lines, you'll find your first impression was mistook. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Should we do the one about the wealthy widow?
Oh, by all means.
Always loved that one.
Well, go on then.
Lady Hyacinth McCall brought all her treasures to a wraith,
where she only wore a smile,
plus two feathers, and a leaf.
So no one tried to rob her, 'cause she barely wore a stitch.
But when you're in your birthday suit,
there ain't much there to show you're rich.
Oh, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. 'Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook. Ta-ra-ta-ta-ta. You'll find your first impression was mistook. Ya-da-da-da. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Oh, give us the one about the dirty rascal, why don't ya? Ain't that one a bit long?
Well, the quicker you're into it, the quicker you're out of it.
Once upon a time in a nursery rhyme, there was a castle with a king hiding in a wing. 'Cause he never went to school to learn a single thing. He had scepters and swords and a parliament of lords, but on the inside he was sad, egad, because he never had a wisdom for numbers, a wisdom for words. Though his crown was quite immense, his brain was smaller than a bird's. So the queen of the nation made a royal proclamation to the misses and the messes, the more or lesses. Bring me all the last professors. Then she went to the hairdressers, and they came from the east and they came from the south. From each college they poured knowledge from their brains into his mouth. But the king couldn't learn, so each professor met their fate, for the queen would have their heads removed and placed upon the gate. And on that date, as did the wife, so got a note, the mate was now the late great. But then suddenly one day a stranger started in to sing. He said, I'm the dirty rascal and I'm here to teach the king. And the queen clutched her jewels, for she hated royal fools. But this fool had some rules that really ought to take his school. Like, you'll be a happy king if you enjoy the things you've got. You should never try to be the kind of person that you're not. So they sang and they laughed, for the king had found a friend. And then they ran onto a rainbow, for the story's perfect end. So the moral is, you mustn't let the outside be the guide, for it's not so cut and dry. Well, unless it's Dr. Jekyll, then you better hide. Petrified! No, the truth can't be denied. As I know I've testified, all that really counts and matters is the special stuff inside.
Oh, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. 'Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook.
So please listen to what we've said and open a book tonight in bed.
So one more time before we get the hook,
sing it out strong.
A cover is nice.
Please take our advice.
A cover is nice.
Oh, you'll pay the price.
A cover is nice, but a cover is not the hook.